preparing for the worst with all hands on deck. It sounds and really looks so real. Luckily, though, this is only a drill, a mass casualty disaster training.
A lot of people involved in this today. First of its kind for Cincinnati. WLWT News 5's Christy Davis was in the middle of all of it to see how the tri-state would handle a tragedy.
Yeah, the drill may actually take place here at the Hamilton County Fairgrounds using agencies from across different counties and different states, but it goes all the way to your smartphone. The day started with a bang, the kind no one wants to hear. An explosion simulating a terrorist attack on a school field trip. Every type of emergency personnel imaginable responds. Nurses even act as real victims.
Actually, we can put what we actually learned in school into it. That way we know what it's really like to be a victim and then to bring it out and like, okay, they should be doing this. We should be, you know, breathing like this.
The more real it feels, from screams to broken glass, the more emergency crews can learn from the experience.
Well, we gather all the information, you know, what we need to do to correct our plan. We've laid our plan out, and now we're going to see if it works.
Most of the drill is part of regular training for first responders. One of the ever-changing challenges is keeping you informed.
Our big thing, I think, that we're learning here today is how we can get the information out.
Big press conferences offer some training, but one major lesson learned from the bombing in Boston, control social media quickly.
We're trying to funnel this information into one local, specific message. And in this situation, we're using the social media with Twitter.
Emergency managers sent fake alerts via Twitter and monitored social media for incorrect information. Valuable knowledge in a new age of disaster management.
We're trying to prepare for something if it was to happen.
Now the assessment phase of the drill begins. They'll look at what worked, what didn't, and what they'll need to change for the future. At the Hamilton County Fairgrounds, Christy Davis, WLWT News 5.